Hello, and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on ionization energies. The ionization energy is the energy required to remove an electron from an atom. The process of removing one electron from a neutral atom is the first ionization energy. You can also have successive ionization energies. The energy required to remove a second electron is the second ionization energy. And likewise, the energy required to remove a third electron is the third ionization energy. The greater the ionization energy, or the more positive the ionization energy, the harder it is to remove an electron. And the ionization energy increases with each successive electron removed. There's a sharp increase in ionization energies. With the removal of an inner shell electron, or removing an electron from the noble gas core. And along with that, electrons in the outermost shells are the easiest to remove. Let's look at the periodic table trend for ionization energy. Ionization energies increase as you go from the bottom to the top of the periodic table. Remember that when you're removing an electron, you're removing it from the outermost shell. As you go down the periodic table, the size of the atoms becomes bigger, and the electrons reside in shells farther and farther away from the nucleus. And so the farther away an electron is from the nucleus, the easier it is to remove that electron. Ionization energy also increases as you move from left to right across the periodic table. Let's look at an example involving ionization energies. Arrange the following atoms in order of decreasing first ionization energy. Francium, oxygen, calcium, and fluorine. And so we want to put these atoms in order from the one that's hardest to remove an electron from to the one that's the easiest to remove an electron from. First, let's locate these elements on the periodic table. Francium, oxygen, calcium, and fluorine. Remember in our periodic trends that ionization energy increases as you go from the bottom to the top and increases as you go from left to right. That means that fluorine would have the highest ionization energy, followed by oxygen, followed by calcium, and francium would be the atom where an electron could be most easily removed. Between which successive ionization energies in an atom of aluminum will we see the greatest increase? So remember, the removal of the first electron is the first ionization energy. The removal of a second electron is the second ionization energy, and so on and so forth. And so we're looking for between which of those ionization energies will we see the greatest increase. Here I've drawn out the electron configuration for aluminum. The first ionization energy is the energy required to remove the 3p electron. Now I've drawn the electron configuration for my aluminum plus 1 ion. The second ionization energy will remove an electron from the 3s shell. And the removal of a third electron will remove an electron again from the 3s shell. So the electron configuration for the aluminum 3 plus ion is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So you can see that now we've removed all of our outer shell electrons. And so between the third and fourth ionization energies is when we would see a sharp increase in ionization energy, because this requires the removal of an electron from an inner shell of aluminum. You might also remember that atoms tend to form ions with the same charge as their group number. So aluminum is in group 3 on your periodic table, and aluminum likes to form ions with a plus 3 charge. This gives it a stable noble gas configuration. So you'll always see a sharp increase in ionization energies between the ion that an atom is most likely to form and the removal of one more electron from that ion. So in the case of aluminum forms ions with a charge of plus 3 because it's in group 3 on the periodic table, And so you'll see a sharp increase in ionization energy between the third and fourth ionization energies, or the removal of one more electron from that ion. It also might be helpful to draw out abbreviated electron configurations with noble gas cores. And then you can write out the electron configurations as you remove each successive electron. And you know that you'll see a sharp increase in ionization energies as soon as you have to remove an electron from that noble gas core. So if we look at this again on our periodic table, you'll see that the loss of one electron from aluminum results in the formation of an aluminum plus one ion, and that has the same electron configuration as magnesium. When we remove one more electron, we form aluminum plus two with the same electron configuration as sodium. And when we lose one more electron, we result in the formation of aluminum plus three with the same electron configuration as neon. And remember, according to the octet rule, atoms like to form ions with stable noble gas configurations and an octet of valence electrons. So once aluminum has the same electron configuration as neon, it's going to be very hard to remove one more electron from that atom. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.